Habarienu, welcome again to the Kenya Films Vlog. My name is Albert Kundi, your host. Today, there's quite a bit to talk about. First of all, of course, start off with the Book of Kaa and Arama, the Afro Space Sentinel. We've had quite a long days in these last couple of weeks. Trying to put this short film, Arama, the Afro Space Sentinel, together. Actually, it's perhaps one of the most enriching things I've done this year so far. More important, it's how we have been able to find solutions to things in post-production that probably some of us never think about, but are really profound when it comes to when we think about it. My co-producer, person doing all the CGI, all the compositing, After Effects, animation, we'll be doing a short, in the next episode, we'll be doing a short tutorial, but you know, behind the scenes on how he was doing some of the work. But we are hoping to do that after we release the film, which is very imminent. Tunataka ku release this week. There is Friday. And we are hoping that we can release it this week, at least over the weekend. So atua kule hiyo wa shibe kabisa. Then Monday, next week we can release the behind the scenes and how we did some of those scenes. Enjoy the logo kwanza. Logo, enjoy. Arama, the Afro Space Sentinel. That is a short film that we are doing that is meant to really work as in different ways. It's meant to achieve many different things. First of all, science fiction, it's not a genre you'd say we specify, we are really focusing on here. In fact, a tremendous search on the internet about African science fiction, there's really very little, and whatever is there really, you can have your opinions about it, but we love the genre and we really like to do something. I think it's really one of those platforms where you can basically go crazy with your imagination. It is a first when you're trying to do something you've never done before. Not that we haven't done film before, but we have not done science fiction. The difference with science fiction is how intensive it is in the technical aspect in post-production, learning, compositing, special effects, animation, and having to film for that. So we have to test ourselves before we shoot the Book of Kaa, but we didn't see where we'll just do a few shots in the house. Why not just at least try and put together a story that people can enjoy at the same time. So that's another reason. Trying to do a little entertaining short film here with a different covers. Listening to Akisi talking or doing things in space could be interesting. The Zanzibar International Film Festival is about to start. I think they've already made the nominations. Kenya this time round has quite a bit of nominations. If I have to take a quick look here at some of them, this is a big number, very big number of Kenyan films, TV, documentaries that have been nominated, which is an improvement. You know, just if things are more, you know, it's better always. And as far as I see the list here, I can tell you for sure that we are going to have a number of winners. Some very powerful films there, some good documentaries, TV programs. So we had, apparently Kenya had 54 entries in the festival. By the way, for those who don't know, Zanzibar or International Film Festival or ZIFF is, I think, one of the biggest film festivals, second or third in Africa, I think. I could be wrong, but I think it's about that. So a big opportunity if you're able to nominate it, or even if you win. From the 54 entries from Kenya, so the following were nominated. We had Supermodel by that's by the One Fine Day Ginger in collaboration Kenya, Germany, directed by Likarion by Naina. But my personal bias, yes, it's a bias, yes, but I think everyone said it's a good film, so it's not like bias to Ivyo. It is a good film, and I think stands a good chance of taking it all. I hope it does. It's already doing very well in various. It has won quite a bit. So I don't see why not here, because it has all the juice. It's a good story, it was shot well. It was edited well. It has been shown, at least for the first time, quite extensively here, abroad. It's still being shown somewhere. I can't even keep track right now. We have 18 Hours, Njue Kevin. I respect this director, Roka Pictures. Roka, I hope I'm pronouncing it right. Roka Pictures. So Kevin Njue, 18 Hours, also a good film. Based on a true story, yule jamaa aliachwa kwa ambulance for 18 hours. That incident. So he did a film about that. I think he's shown it quite a bit. I think it's somewhere also showing. I wish people would have access to these films a lot easier. Yes. So there is The Cut by Peter Wangugi Gitao. There is those are feature films, really. And then there's quite a number of documentaries. Flesh Business documentary by Dennis Wanjohi Maina, which is also, by the way, on Showmax. So I think if you're on Showmax, unaweza enda uione. It's about prostitution at the coast. I hear it's pretty well done. I haven't watched it, really, but the trailer does give it a bit of weight. It feels like it's that well done. Kuna Who Am I, it's a documentary by Wanori Kahio of Rafiki Fame. So she has a documentary at Zif. And I hear only kuna ubaya, it will be the documentary feature film inside. There's a number of short films. There is Boxed, there is Clench, there is Imara, there is Pendo, and Neophobia. TV series, Ballin Africa, Ballin, yenye mayuto anasemanga. Career Talk, Fihi, Giving Nature a Voice, Keru, Lamsingi, The Wives, Tumaini Center. This is a good sign. Which takes me to the next point, where the Kenya Film Commission did actually support 11 of these filmmakers who were, I think, filmmakers, actors. It's a combination. I don't know if you can call them the same. I don't. But they supported 11 of these guys. I think it's the biggest number of independent filmmakers being supported by the government agency. Kenya Film Commission to go to a film festival, if my memory serves me right, which makes a bit of an indicator to me that at least for now things are changing for the better, that at least there is more recognition. And 11 is a big number, considering that before maybe 2 or 3 would go or something like that. Which this is a big up, which I believe has been, which must be celebrated. On top of that, I can speak, or I've asked Kenya Film Commission to support me on my Book of Car endeavor, and they were very positive about everything I suggested. Of course, you wouldn't get everything you want, it's not how it works, but what I got, I'm very happy about, or at least what has been promised. What has been promised, I'm happy about, and I can't complain at all. So thank you hapo, asante sana hao Kenya Film Commission kwa kusaidia wa mayuti, because by the way, these nominations, these guys are roughly between, to me they look like all them are like 25 or below, which is, it, you can't complain when, you know, young guys like that are just jumping in there and doing work, you know, getting nominated for such a prestigious festival. No complaint at all. And that shows at least that the future is bright. So the, all these things we are doing right now, we must, you know, the interest is there from every corner. The young people are here, you know. I'm not saying about that, that's, those are the only important people, but, you know, the older us, I don't know, I'm in between the young people and the wale wazee walianza kitambo. So I don't know, all I can say is that I'm happy the young people are doing it. I wish the older guys will do it a bit more. I wish Tutaeza Shikana Tufanya a lot more film. It's a great, you know, great career choice for many people in the future. A great business opportunity. It's a cultural endeavor like no other. We need to just get on with it, you know. Just so I'm happy this is happening. I'm happy Kenya Film Commission. By the one of the guys I hear who were nominated at was from a program from the coast somewhere, like on Kilifi or something. That the Kenya Film Commission had done a project sensitizing and some trainings there. So those guys from that did a short film that the other competition recently, the mobile phone film competition, they won that. They're also part of the people that have been nominated yet. So it's a classic example of, you know, if you just invest in the people and what they are doing, right, things they will come up with favor. If they are honest, genuine hard workers, the result is there. So everything I've talked about here, you can find at the bottom here, somewhere there are the comments on the descriptions, the links to the trailer, the trailers of things I've talked about, and of course some of the articles talking about what the Kenya Film Commission, and of course Kenya Film Commission website and whatnot, just so we engage more. And for the next one, I'm going to be on the next episode, we're going to be speaking more about the execution of the short film Arama, the Afro-Space Sentinel. And I'm going to speak about some new things Kenya Film Commission is putting in place to try and set it up, you know, set up the sector in a manner, you know, a lot of like accreditation and a lot of other things. So I forget, it's the long list. I'm going to talk about it next week, next episode. Then we can, that I think is important, because some of this, many of the suggestions they have there are sensible, and I think we should back them. You too, because us. Peace.